not trying to, the only reason I bring it up now, what it's relevant to, is the fact that there are people who, as a result of being charged in part with prostitution, end up going to prison, and rape is never part of anybody's sentence, but the fact that these people are targeted as prostitutes kind of gives you additional pause as to what I think about what the policy should be concerned with. I'm just going to wait and have everybody else go on. I'm going to ask members of the public to see if they have a good one.
Well, I just wanted to clarify once again what Liz was saying. This is not a bill to decriminalize prostitution.
I understand that, but we're studying to decriminalize it still. I mean, that's what the word is, isn't it?
With respect to what you just previously told me about the study, I would like to just point out that the choice of language that is in this piece of legislation right now proposing the study committee is not neutral, and that we have to be very careful about the language that we use because it will create a version of reality. And as of right now, there is no such labor recognized by the Department of Labor in the state of New Hampshire for sex work. That is not something that exists. So we have to be very careful about whether we are changing a statewide policy and incorporating an industry into our labor discussions by using the word sex work, when actually it's my assertion that we're talking about people who are prostituted and victims of prostitution. And I think if, you know, through the learning opportunities that are available this summer and some of the things coming out this fall about human trafficking and prostitution, I hope you all will join me in them. It will broaden our perspective about using that language, because starting to normalize people who are prostituted by calling them sex workers, we'll be incorporating that into our labor laws. And I shut